It's the language of an oppressed people. And therefore, it develops subtleties that do not exist in languages of oppressing people. For example, a Jew has to be careful about what he says, because there are punishable situations that he tries to avoid. And therefore, he will do with a nuance, which is very expressive, that doesn't, it's hard to reproduce in other languages.
If you say, what does this guy do? Er's a doctor. He's a doctor. If you want to say he's a wonderful doctor, er's a doctor. If you want to say the guy's a quack, er's a doctor. So that famous rise-fall intonation that, of course, has influenced English, is very prominent in Yiddish.
My famous example is a telegram that Trotsky sent to Stalin at the time of the Congress in Russia, in which the telegram overtly says, "Dear comrade, you are right. I am wrong. Socialism can be built in one country. Long may you prosper," something like that. And he rushed in and he showed the telegram to his Jewish brother-in-law and said, "You see, this is a great victory, a complete capitulation of Trotsky." So the Jewish brother-in-law said, "Wait a moment, comrade Stalin, you don't know how to read this telegram. Here's how it should be read. Dear comrade, you are right. I am wrong. Socialism can be built in one country. Long may you prosper. Signed, Trotsky." It's adapting itself to modern technology and modern science with a whole new glossaries of vocabulary. The one that comes to mind at the moment is shmekldecker. It's the word for condom. Schmeckel is a brick, if you want to say that, and decker is a cover. Shmekldecker.